There we go.
There! Hey, we're finally live.
Yeah, it's the Beer and 420 show.
Oh, yeah.
Got the Millennial Tart working. April's working. Kluge's playing with his balls. We might get a show up from the president, Will Height, and who knows? We'll try to get some Dr. Sage questions. If not, we'll do a little bit more of my thoughts. Whatever else we might come up with.
And Tim might show up, or he's playing Tim with his wiener.
Tim's cool. I like his rants. His rants are pretty cool.
Nah. Bubba's in here already. What's up, fucker?
Bubba's cool. Bubba's one of our biggest fans, literally and figuratively.
Let's start this show off, offense, right? Bubba.
I'm big too. I understand. No, I meant that. Not.
This is the Beer and 420 show. We got the beer.
Hey, you'll be surprised at me. I'm going to get a 12-pack of PBR tomorrow.
All right.
So, I adulted at the beginning of the week, and I have a little bit of money left, so I'm like, you know what? I'm going to treat myself and get myself some PBR this morning. What's up, Spooner?
I'm going to turn that ringer off real quick here.
Oh, I thought you had the Star Wars thing. The Star Wars ringer. The ringy dingy.
Oh, hell no.
Then who's the one that has the Star Wars ringy dingy?
It's probably Kluge.
Oh, that's right.
What up, Spoon? How you doing, buddy? Are you taking care of invites, 420?
Yeah, I'm sending it out to people I know.
Alrighty.
We're trying to talk at the same time, but I can do that unlike the
Millennial Tart.
The Millennial Tart.
Yeah. Yeah, and us older generation, we know how to multitask.
What's new with you?
Oh, man, heading into a busy weekend. That's why I was really thinking I was going to be late getting on here tonight with having to come in and set up and get ready for the show. Uh-huh. I had to go down, fuel up the truck real quick, and then I was planning on coming back and going ahead and hooking up the trailer and stuff before I lose daylight, and I was like, shit, I got to go in and get this show ready. So I didn't get a chance to hook it up. I guess I'll have to do that in the middle of the dark. And because I got to be at the venue tomorrow morning at like 8 o'clock to start setting up the ring.
Oh, that's right. This weekend is the one of those wrestling.
Yeah, got a show down in Litchfield.
That's right. That's right.
Yep. All right, Spoon.
So you don't have to. So are you using your? Wait. So you're not using your ring and everything?
Oh yeah, I'm using my ring. That's why I got to hook up the trailer. And
oh, I thought you usually do that on Friday nights. Get it set up.
I usually do, but I wasn't going to leave my ring outside set up.
Oh, that's right, because it's an outside event this time.
Yeah. Okay. Gotcha. And unattended, so. No, that's that's an insurance violation on my part if I were to do that.
Because if someone got on it and hurt themselves, and
I'd be held liable for it. The only other option was me spending the night outside with my ring, and it's going to be like 40-some degrees overnight, and there's no way in hell.
It's only supposed to get the high of like 58 to 60 tomorrow. Mm. But yet, there's a dirt track in my area that decided to do a race just to have a race. And it's like, it's going to be cold.
Well, luckily for us wrestlers, once we're up inside that ring, you know, it'll be okay.
Don't you wish you had the ring that WWE had for that one pay-per-view they had where it was outside, and they had these huge heaters underneath the ring, and each post had its own heater, and it was constantly blowing 75-degree air out into the ring to where it was 75 degrees in the ring, but outside of the ring, it was like 55, 60.
Oh, that would be fantastic.
I can't remember what was that. It was either it wasn't a WrestleMania. It was like it was one of the ones that happened like in the wintertime, fall time, right around there. Like a Survivor Series, I think it was, or something like that.
Oh, Bubba, the millennial vagina is at work.
Millennial vagina.
He's playing with his Reynolds wrap.
He's guarding doors.
Yeah, guarding doors. He'll probably pop on during one of his breaks, and you'll see him standing, smoking a cigarette, guarding the door.
Mm-hmm. And if you didn't see the recent picture I posted, go to our page and look at it after the show.
Oh, yeah, it works.
I'm coming up with good ones.
Oh, on to other news about my my company. My tag belts came in.
Ooh, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, they're fancy.
Nice. You know, speaking of belts, I was thinking about this the other day. I see a lot of people online complaining about like AEW and WWE. Oh, they got too many belts. They need to get rid of one, blah, blah, blah. It's like, have any of you looked at AAA?
Yeah, no kidding. Seriously.
Or even New Japan. AAA, they have the Mega Champion. Then they have a U.S. Champion. Then they have a Latin America Champion. Then they have a Cruiserweight Championship. Then they have one other kind of world champion, and that's just the guys. That's not even tag teams. Tag teams, they have a tag team. They have a triple, a six-man tag team belt. They have a woman's belt and like one or two more. So they got like 10, 15 belts. New Japan, they have... The IWGP belt. They have the TV championship. They have like a cruiserweight. They have the U.S. title. They just have a bunch. I mean, even but if you even want to be local, like NWA, they have two of everything pretty much. So yep. If there's a world champion, a world tag team champion, a world cruiserweight championship. They have they even have a TV championship, so there's four. They even have a U.S. tag team champion. They have a U.S. champion. So it's like, my point being is that these people are complaining about AEW having the extra trios champion, and it's like, if you look at all these other places, they have just as many.
Do you know the YouTube link 420?
Let me get it real quick. Where is it? Why is it? Oh, that's why, because it.
What's up, Corey?
So, anyway, you know, so I just find it comical. And then someone the other day, they were arguing about how if it wasn't for WWE, AEW, New Japan wouldn't have great wrestlers. And I'm like, well, you little
mook. Oh, wait. Yeah, I don't know about that.
I'm like, well, you little mook, if it wasn't for Independent and New Japan, WWE wouldn't be around. So...
I don't know so much about that because WWE has been around, I mean, since WWWF.
Well, I mean, back then, yes. But what I'm saying is in nowadays, the wrestler nowadays, because Kevin Owens, he was in what? ROH. He was, I think he was in New Japan for a couple years.
He was in New Japan. But even before then, he was in Canada, Canadian Stampede.
Yeah, and all these other ones. And my point being is that if it wasn't for the indies, a lot of the wrestlers nowadays.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. And most wrestlers did start in the indies. I mean,
even if you did look at the back then, you still had Smoky Mountain Wrestling, right?
Smoky Mountain. AWA.
AWA and all. And there is, what was the one on the East Coast that was big back in the day? Was that AWA or?
AWA, Smoky Mountain, because Vern Gagne was in charge of one of them.
Right.
I think that was AWA. You're asking me to get into the history, and I'm thinking, and I can't think right now. I got so much other shit going on in my head.
Because
back then it was divided into territories.
Well, that's what
and
I'm
you
saying.
Had, yeah, the WWF, which was in the Stanford, New York area. And then you come on down to the South and you had like Mid-South Wrestling and the AWA and hell, you had Texas Stampede Wrestling. California had its own fucking thing too, and I can't remember what it was. You had Mid-Atlantic.
Right. Mid-South, okay. Yeah. I posted the link for the YouTube in our chat. So you guys all can click on that. But yeah, my point being is that if it wasn't for all these smaller organizations and these people honing their skills there, a lot of the wrestlers we know nowadays wouldn't be known unless you're someone like you or me who's a wrestling fanatic and.
Oh, yeah, and followed wrestling for years.
Follow all wrestling, which
yeah, not just stick to
on
one.
My subscriptions, I got OVW, I got MLW, I got NWA, I got one that is called something Championship Wrestling, but it has like Memphis Championship Wrestling. There's a two or three other ones that are part of this organization. It's kind of
Memphis,
like
Memphis Championship Wrestling. That's the one that Jerry the King Lawler owns. I'm pretty sure.
It might be. I don't know. I mean, they don't ever show them on there at all, but it's basically in this really small cracker box looking not even a gym. It's like a small room, and it's big enough for the ring and maybe like three rows of chairs all the way around, and in the corner is where they come out and the announcers are, and that's as big as it is.
Damn, the small-ass building.
Yeah, but it's always packed. They're on YouTube all the time, and I kind of like it. And they even once in a while have like a lot of the big stars. Like just recently they had Tommy Dreamer on there for a few episodes, which I thought was pretty cool. You know?
Hmm.
So, I got the link. So,
what's up? Send it. The link is not working. Becky, hello.
I don't know why it's not. It's the exact same thing. I copy and pasted it, so I don't know what else to say unless someone else can copy and paste it for us. Let me try this other way.
Eric Stuntsman?
See, now we're going to get echoes. Let's see. I'll hit the share button. I'll copy that one.
I'm doing pretty good tonight. Tired. But, I mean, it's going to be a friggin' long weekend. I'm glad tomorrow's not going to be very long. Too,
because, like I said, tomorrow I'm going to be busy doing some housework stuff that I need. Was being lazy on. Then I'm leaving to get some food, you know, do some of that, you know, some errands. And then I'm going to, hopefully there'll be some people there at the racetrack and do some tailgating there. And then hopefully they don't cancel it. And they'll be racing there all night. So I'm going to be
like, I'm just warm.
All right. Let's see if I can. See, that's the same exact link that I sent Corey. So, anyway, so what's everybody up to? Is everybody doing good? Do they got plenty of weed and beer since it's the beat? That's all, folks, man. It's freaking night. Gosh, I've been doing that all week, just been stuttering over everything.
The beer and 420 show?
The beer and 420 show. Searching it's good. Okay, now that if you're on it, depending on what browser you're on,
thank you.
Hit the save button. Oh, we got
AB.
Hello.
Wow, the show just jumped up 5 viewers.
I have all my clothes on.
What the hell?
I'm at work.
Okay, that's understandable.
Oh, I can see what she meant by where she's at now. I can see the yellow.
Unfortunately, no, honey. We don't have a feather bat.
Ooh. I want that in the bat. I want that bat on that stand. Ooh, I like that.
She muted us.
Probably because it's echoing.
I'll be sure I'm talking to my team members.
Oh.
So I do a podcast with my buddies. Say hi.
What's up?
I normally am off work by now to join them.
Yes, Connor. She's at work because she's the boss of the store. So usually bosses have to stay forever. So
yes, I don't have to stay forever.
It's hard to quit.
The store can't survive without her.
Right.
I'm sorry.
Oh, good night. You know, I was thinking about my truck the other day, and I was thinking instead of buying a topper, what I was going to do is buy one of those ladder racks and put it on, and then take the extra stock car body panels that I have and do that as my sidings and roof. Kind of like a conversation type piece and rednecking it.
Okay.
Because it's kind of hard to find one that'll fit mine because I got the shorter bed. Because I found one for $100 today, but it was for the longer bed. It was for the 8-foot bed. Mine's 6.5.
Yeah, we can cut it down.
I'm sure we could, but I need a welder to freaking weld it back.
Looks like Chris is staying at a motel now. That's going to suck.
I know what that's like, Bubba, because I did that a few years ago. 20 years ago when I was moving from with my dad to somewhere else. I had to live in a motel for like 2 to 3 weeks.
I'll be in one at the end of the month in Juliet. Yeah.
Connor, count. I just do it. I go until that bowl gets empty, and then what happens, happens.
And then you refill it and go again.
Exactly. So I texted my skin a couple times, no response. So I called her quick search voicemail. So I called her dad. I was like, Princess with you? He's like, yeah. I was like, okay, well, because I called her and I've texted her a few times, I'm not getting a response. He's like, so he hollered at her and he's like, did you let your mom know that she got dropped off?
So in your
my phone back.
That gets passed away a few days ago.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, he's pretty old, so
he was 80.
Yeah, and then all the years that he played with tackling people and everything, it probably took a toll on him too as well. So
yeah, that's a good thing. I mean, shit.
It don't help, but
I would still rather probably live past 80.
Uh-huh. All right, I just shared it with JD, so hopefully he'll come in for us.
Oh, man, that means he's just going to come in here and be like, Sage is gay.
Sage is gay. That gets back up every time.
Yeah.
Just think of what happens if we had JD, Skeletor, and Mike all at the same time.
I would probably fall out of my chair and just die. I couldn't handle all that shit. Especially if I was doing a Dr. Sage segment and they all just attack me at the same fucking time. I'd just be like, I'm done! No. Becky says that would be entertaining.
Right, Becky?
I would not be able to combat that. It would just be like, fuck. Yeah. Put a fork in me. I'm done. Yeah, that would be a bad situation all the way around.
Oh, God damn it.
Oh, God damn it.
The truth hurts sometimes.
Spoon! Brother! Damn!
Yeah, send it.
Irene.
5 years ago, before I got this place, I pretty much had everything I could fit in the back of my Astro van, and I slept sitting up. For a few weeks in the middle of, at the really start of winter, so November, December.
Oh, fuck.
Well, I know what these people are talking about, so I really have empathy, or is that right? Is that the right way to say it?
You empathize and sympathize.
Yeah, I know what they're going through. I know exactly what they're, and it's not fun.
Hey, is anybody else doing a show tonight?
Not that I noticed yet.
Yeah, I haven't seen anything pop up either. Was it down by a river? I live in a van down by the river.
Technically, Eric, yes, it was, because I was. It was a little bit over in Pekin, and it was a little bit in East Peoria, and a little bit in Peoria.
Jesus, you had a big van. But it was an Astro van. It was a 93 Astro.
98.
Oh, my bad. I just left off part of the three.
And it was all-wheel drive, too.
Hey, man, those things were awesome. My mom had one.
I loved it. That's another reason why I loved getting, when I found out that this truck was a 4x4, it's like, oh, this would be cool. Now I'll be can drive a little better in wintertime.
And that's a Ford, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, goddamn it, Skeletor.
It has an off-road package too, which the other day when I was getting my spare tire put on the rim that I bought, I seen one of the exact same year. It's pretty much the exact same thing. The only difference was mine had the off-road package and theirs 4x4 didn't. So mine sat up another almost foot compared to the same exact truck as mine that I had, which was nice.
It's got the off-road package, but does it have off-road tires or are they just all-terrain?
Basic ones for now.
Basic bitch tires.
Yeah, well, you got to remember what kind of job I have.
I get it.
You know, if I had the money, I would have a set of frickin' mudders in storage somewhere right now.
No, you don't want mudders.
That way I can go off-road. Or off-road tires, whatever you want to call them.
No, good all-terrains will get you through just about anything. Mine are a little more aggressive than all-terrains.
Right.
GMC Safari, okay, yeah.
I do want to go off-roading with it and everything. I just don't have
the money. See, whenever you do that, that's when shit breaks. And that's not always a good thing.
Yeah, true.
Me, I don't take my truck off-roading or anything like that. I mean, it's a 95. It's rode a pretty fucking hard life, and I'm getting ready to fucking gussy it all up and pretty the whole bitch and give it a whole new paint job and all that shit. So I don't want to go breaking anything. I just want to fucking make it nice. Oh, yeah.
I get that part.
I'm getting ready to fucking do some upgrades to the motor, and I got a fucking cowl induction hood I'm throwing on it and all that shit. So
right on.
My truck's going to be more of a beast.
And Connor, yes, it was very comfortable. That's why I had a 98 and a 99. And before that, I had a 98 Blazer, so which that thing pulled a stock car, an open stock car, two axle stock car trailer like it was nothing. Which I was surprised for that Vortec V6 being able to pull a trailer like that.
I had a 2000 Chevy Blazer and it was pretty tough. It went head to head on a pulling contest with a 98 V8 Dodge Durango.
Well, there you go. You said Dodge.
Yeah. And it was a V8. And it fucking matched up power.
You know, I did like my Dodge. It's just now that I find out that their transmissions are a bunch of shit, that it's like, I kind of wish I knew that 4 years ago when I was looking for vehicles. I would have. And see, the thing is, 4 years ago when I got it, everything was running fine. It was just the last 6 months where everything just started just to go bad on it. And I think from what my friend was saying, because he had one of those $5,000 mechanics iPads, whatever you want to call them, that when you plug it in and drive it around and everything, it'll tell you everything that needs to do it and then some type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
He said it was a part that was inside the transmission. I'm like, don't they put something like sensors outside? He's like, nope, this one's inside. So I went and called a few places and they're like, yeah, it's still going to be about $3,000 just to get it fixed. I'm like, what do you mean? Oh, well, you got to drop the pan and then you got to take the part out and then you got to drain the pan and you got to clean it up, put the pan on, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, damn, I might as well just, it wasn't worth fixing. And then I'm going to try to sell it before I give it to a junkyard. And I put the whole description on it. I mean, I detailed everything, you know, right? On Facebook Marketplace. I still get calls going, How's the transmission on it? Since it says the transmission's bad, I said, please reread the description. I said, it says it is toast. Then someone calls in and goes, oh, is it still available? I'm like, read the description. The description, the first thing it says, if this post is still up, it's available. I just find it funny how people don't learn how to read when it comes to things like that. Skelter wants to know if you detailed your nutsack while you're doing your truck.
What the fuck?
Yeah, he said he wants to know if you detailed your nutsack.
Only the ones that are hanging on the back of the truck.
See, that's another thing I was thinking about doing. I was thinking of going to like Fastenal or unless they have for better, big nuts at Menards and get those big nuts that are like, you know, like two nuts and have a big, huge wire and hang on the back of my truck.
I thought about getting them, but my truck has enough balls anyway. That big old Chevy 350 in there.
Oh, yeah. Don't get me wrong. I love 350s because my dad had an 81 El Camino. That was the six cylinder, had, what was it, 302, 306 in it, whatever it was.
Mm-hmm.
And he got, I can't remember the exact make and model, but it was like a 350 four-bolt main from like a 76 car that he put in there, right? And he put a 350 turbo transmission in it. He bumped up the cam. He put a aluminum Elderbrock airflow intake, a 650 Elderbrock carb in it. He took the air condition thing off of it and took the fan off of it and put two electric fans on it and put ceramic headers on it with true dual exhaust out the back. Tell you what, this thing had balls on it. You had to literally ease off the clutch and ease off everything, the gas in the clutch. Because if you too quick, it would bark it on first gear.
Yeah, see, I've got the same engine with the four-bolt main and all that shit, but I've got one of the shit transmissions, like the – what he's talking about, the 416E bullshit transmissions. I got to get something better. And the electronic shift and all that shit, and I hate it. But I probably got to replace that transmission eventually.
Well, I do know the...
I also want, like, the Z71. I want to get the Z71 rear end for my truck because it's just got the standard 4x4 rear end in it right now.
Right, right.
And the Z71's got the Positrac instead of the limited slip like I have.
Oh, okay. Right.
And I want Positrac.
Right. Well, of course. And the cool thing about the Ford that I got – it don't have the push button 4x4. It has the shifter on the floor.
That's how mine is. Shifter on the floor.
The guy that I got it from said that I needed to warm it up for a little bit or something when I put it in the 4x4. Or...
You're also supposed to put it in neutral, too.
Do what now?
You're also supposed to put it in neutral before you shift it to four-wheel drive.
So... basically, you're at a standstill, you put it in neutral, reach on the floor, shift it in the fourth, then you put it back in drive?
Yeah.
Okay. That's good to know, because I plan on going to find a big, huge, empty parking lot, see how good of donuts I can do in 4x4.
Only do that in 4 high, don't do that in 4 low.
Oh, yeah.
Man, you'll tear that fucking shit up. And don't get your RPMs too fucking high either.
Oh yeah, I don't ever, like, if it starts getting too high, I slow down and stop. I mean, even when I had my 91 Ford Escort GT, that thing had a tach in it and a stick. I put it in reverse and I do the donuts in reverse and everything. And when it got up to, you know, a certain amount, I stopped and. I know. Oh yeah, I'm gonna definitely make sure it's in the snow. Cause isn't 4x4 low basically if you're like super really stuck?
Yeah.
Well, I don't plan on wanting to use it at all, but I got it just in case, I guess is what I'm saying. I'm just wanting to have a little bit of fun with it, you know. But, you know, it's something I never had before. It sounds like something I can have fun with as long as I have the proper stuff for it. Whereas the Astrovans, the Blazers, the shit vets, and I kind of wish I still had my Camaro, though, was a thing. Even though it was a Berlinetta. I call it Berlinetta, but whatever it's called. It was like 80, 88, 85, 86. Berlinetta T-tops. Did I tell you about that one?
No.
Anyway, I got it, you know, for like $1,500, $2,000 or something. And I took the T-tops off and it going home one day and it was getting a little cold, right? So I start rolling up. All of a sudden I hear this big old thud type noise. I'm like, crap, I got a flat. So I rolled down the window and all of a sudden it started going away and I'm like, what the heck? So I rolled it back up and it started to come back. So come to find out it was the air coming in through the T-tops and hitting the windows and flapping the windows. I'm like, thank goodness it wasn't a tire, because come to find out the spare tire was flat too. And that's why I got a little extra up when I bought this thing, so I can have a spare tire. And the thing is, even though it's just the spare tire, the rim looks like one of the rims off of a Ford F-150 Lightning, because it has little arrows like things instead of what the ones here look like. I mean, I guess as long as it fits, you know.
Yeah, I'm screwed if I get a flat. I don't have any spares the same size tires as are on my truck. These are big tires.
Then even though it has a jack in it, but it's one of those scissor jacks, I went to Harbor Freight and got a 3-ton floor jack. So that way I can have a floor jack instead of the scissor jack. So that way it'll be a little bit more stable if I have to change a tire.
I got me a fucking trailer, or like a farm jack.
One of those. Oh, yeah. I remember those because my mom had one on her 70. She said it wasn't a Nova, even though I could have swore it was a Nova. Impala.
No, I'm going to mount it on the inside of the bed of my truck somewhere, either on the tailgate or on the side on the inside, whenever I get my truck all the way done.
Right.
Just because my truck sits higher and I can get a floor jack under there, but at the same time, if I'm out on the side of the road somewhere and I need to jack up, that thing's so easy. Just lift it up and fucking. And that thing will lift, you know, several. It's a 4-ton jack, so it'll lift all sorts of shit.
Corey said he had an 85 F-150 4x4. 300 straight six granny 4-speed short bed. She was sitting on 32s. That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, the old Widowmaker jack. Yep.
Yep. I remember one of those. But, you know, and then the only thing I didn't get is because I pretty much ran out of money, was I didn't get an impact and I didn't get a socket. Yeah, I got a four-way for it, but if I can get it done quicker, especially with my health issues, it's going to be easier for me just to go You know?
Hey, Amanda, what's up? Yeah, see, I've got the wireless impact that I carry in my truck all the time, and my lug nuts take a special socket that I always keep in my glove box. So,
what kind of impact are you using?
It's one I got from Harbor Freight that just fucking it'll fucking do anything. It's so great.
Pretty much the inexpensive one at Harbor Freight will be fine just for what I'm doing then.
Yeah, I paid like $60 for mine.
Okay, and yeah, that's what I was wondering.
It's a high torque impact.
Right.
And it's just a little handheld one.
Yeah, that's all I'm going to do is use it for that. You know, just get everything.
Yeah, and I got two batteries with it, and I use it all the fucking time.
Oh Lord! Well, if I didn't
get Corey, you're right.
It wasn't on purpose. It's just.
But my truck is well protected. It's locked all the time. It's got an alarm system on it, and the other alarm system's a 9mm or a 45. So I mean, it's well protected.
You do what now?
He says you're not supposed to tell where your lug security socket is. And I told him my truck's well protected by a security system, an alarm, doors are always locked, and the other security is a 9mm or a 45.
There you go. And that's another thing I need to do is
I'm pretty good security myself, so.
That is true. That's another thing I need to get to is that an actual, because you mentioned it, I need to get an actual key fob for it too, because I'm getting tired of having to do this number when I'm used to the key fob, you know?
Those could be expensive, bro.
Yeah. I can get an aftermarket one at like Ace or something. Because they're selling those, but it's like, how do I know what one to get?
Yeah.
And if I go to the Ford dealer, they're going to want like $150, $200 for it. And it's like, well, you know, I don't care if it says Ford on the damn thing. I just want it to freaking work.
Yeah, no shit.
F-150, Connor. For 2003. So I think I sent it out to the people I could.
His other security is a can of Twisted Tea. That's fucking true, too.
There you go. Twisted Tea. And Did I send that to you, or did I forget to send it to you? There is this picture I seen of the road signs, and one says tailgating with beer, and the other one said tailgating with Twisted Tea, and it had these two guys carrying a cooler that said Twisted Tea on it, and they're going up the off ramp to the Twisted Tea tailgating.
No, I didn't see that.
I didn't send it to you, but I thought that was kind of funny.
No, Tyler just sent me Dr. Sage questions.
You want to read them and answer them, or you want me to read them and you answer them?
Did he send them to the group chat?
I don't know. Did he?
I'm not really sure. Let's see. You sent them to the best damn podcast.
All right. Well, if you want to do that, we can do that right now. How many people do we got? I don't know. I didn't.
We've only got six.
So you want to wait another 5-10 minutes and then do it, or you want to just
Wait until the top of the hour, or?
So, yeah.
Oh, well, Skeletor's got the shits.
Sorry about that, buddy. Next time you shouldn't eat Evil Wind out like that.
Well, you know, your one true love, Kluge's playing with his balls tonight.
Yeah. See, the thing is, if your blow-up doll is oozing out the nose, it's not that it's sick. It's that it's too full.
Yeah. Should we do about five stoner thoughts tonight too.
Do you got the Rona there, Amanda?
Oh, she's got the Rona. My Corona.
We can do a few until the top of the hour. You know, I was thinking.
You need your music?
We can do without it unless you know where it is.
Let me see here if he's got it labeled. Oh, he does. I'll be damned. This almost sounds like you remember Vitamin C, the fucking graduation song.
Oh yeah.
As we go now.
Why do you gotta fucking do it so loud?
God, 420, God damn it. Yes.
Jesus Christ, 420. No, you're not. Anyway. All right. Corey says, Confucius says, man who goes to bed with itchy booty hole wakes up with a sticky finger.
Oh.
Well, that is true. You know what, Amanda? That could be true because there are the farmers are harvesting, so that shit gets kicked up. So anyway, back to you, 420. You know, I set my standards high. Well, I do everything high, though. Is Dr. Stick? There we go. That'll work. We don't have to put music up. It's fine.
Well, that's good because I don't even know how to.
The Kentucky Derby, the Amish version of NASCAR.
Yes. Yes, it is.
What do lesbians and turtles have in common? They both choke on plastic. You can't spell advertisement without semen between the tits. I think I said that Wednesday, but that's okay.
I think you did, yes.
Because it took Tyler like 5 minutes to figure it out. But that's a millennial for you, right, guys? And gals? And whatever you want to call yourself? Is a group of Karens called a homeowners association? If humans can hold their breath for 5 minutes underwater, how did they film SpongeBob? Is a different. Why am I reading these? I read these already. Well, that's why, because I'm on the wrong one. See, that's what happens when you're stoned. Especially when you get this. Especially when you ingest Haswell County weed. It's different wherever you get it. Okay, here we go. This should be it. Come on. Here we go. If someone overcooked a brisket, is it drier than a scarecrow pussy?
Oh.
When an orphan gets married, is it a family and is it a legacy? Is the worst thing about playing hide and seek with a creepy uncle is who's the winner? Because it's either going to be a buckshot or a backshot.
Oh my God.
We should rename flashbangs to the Helen Keller test because once it goes off like Helen Keller, you're not going to hear or see shit.
Jesus.
Do you know that daddy issues and lactose intolerance have something in common? Like when your father, when he left to go get a carton of milk, and every time you see a carton of milk, you know you something that you can't have? Would it be wrong to pretend that a tall woman's boobs is a viewfinder in a periscope? You know. Because if you stand up and you have a tall woman, their boobs are usually right in your face. So you can, yeah. See? How many farts would it take to fill up a balloon? If leaves on a tree produce oxygen, then how are the oxygen levels not affected when leaves fall and trees are bare?
What the fuck?
I don't know. If big fish eat smaller fish, why don't big birds eat smaller birds? Don't know. The fiction is the truth, and nonfiction is actual fiction with subliminal messages making us conform to the rules and trends of society. Do aliens smoke?
Well, Paul did.
Well, true. And last but certainly not least, how would cats use scissors? Because they have the paw, so they have no real fingers to hold on to the scissors. So how would they?
Yeah, I don't think cats are meant to use scissors.
Well, like I said, it's things I come up with when I'm stoned.
Cats and scissors? No, I would hope not.
Flashbangs is also what happens when a bunch of white guys fuck a black chick. That's what Connor says.
Oh, Jesus.
Sometimes I forget that too, Amanda, especially when I get pretty busy. But as soon as I walk out the door and I look and I see the field and it is empty out in the night before it was full, I know.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure it's always harvest season around October, fall. It happens at the same time every year. It's so weird. God damn it!
Oh, Jesus crap! Why you gotta do that right in the microphone for?
You know, I'm really surprised Tyler hasn't been in here yet.
You think you need relationship advice, Spoon? Well,
you come to the right podcast.
Yeah.
We will fuck your life up even worse.
Yeah, I guess we could.
Well, there's an email we can go to. I still need that hug, Dr. Sage. Well, next time I see you.
Ask drsage@gmail.com.
Yes. You can always go to that email and send in your questions, and I'll give you some advice. But next time I see you at the gas station, I'll give you a good old hug.
Well, who was that last time, that thought those glasses were real? Was that Tyler?
Ah, I can't remember who it was that thought they were real. And they used to be real until I dropped them on the concrete and broke one of the lens, and then I just popped both the lens out.
That's another thing, too. I had this phone, not the phone I have now. I had another phone. I had the phone forever. I dropped it and everything. It worked fine. And all of a sudden, the other day, I dropped it, And then all of a sudden, it stopped working. And I'm like, really? And it wasn't cracked or anything. It just stopped working. Huh. So now I got to find my second phone for whatever. Anyway. All right. Top of the hour. Would you like to do the Dr. Sage questions now there, Dr. Sage?
Oh, well, let me grab a beer. As I just glanced at them briefly.
Did you?
Yeah, and I'm like, oh boy. So I know these are probably gonna make me cry or blush or shake my head a couple times. Let's see, 420. I have an idea for the company at work. A little lower unit that pressurizes each other. Let's put 40 pounds of the strongest wind for all shit. Hot box camper.
Spoon, let's just put it this way. One too many. I think I'm going to read these from top to bottom for you. So let me know when you're ready. And I'll read them the best I can.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah. Man, I'm getting all these good ones out and Tyler ain't even here.
Yeah, no kidding.
So, like I said, send your questions, ask Dr. Sage, and we'll get them next week because the millennial has all the stuff and he can't give it to us.
But at least he sent them to us tonight.
At least
so.
Three of them. So, yeah, if you want to private message us them, just let us know. And we'll try
if you have any you want to throw right here in the chat tonight, go right ahead.
Or there too, if you feel comfortable enough to do that.
Yeah.
Which I know. Mike and Skeletor and Connor and a few others don't mind. So, the first question for Dr. Sage tonight is, dear Dr. Sage, I was listening after hours and I'm wondering, why do you get so many man trolls that target you? First it was Mike, then it was Skeletor. Are you a guy magnet? Signed, you all need Jesus.
You know, that's a damn good question. And the truth is, I really, really don't know. I used to be a magnet to the women, and they would, like, flock to me. But since being here on this show and putting on, it might be the freaking glasses. I don't know. Or the beard, maybe the long hair.
It could be that Trump hat too.
That oh shit no, and it could be. But I don't always wear the hair, or the hat. I mean, sometimes the hair is just down in there, and I'm kind of afraid to throw the PBR hat back on because, hell, that cowboy hat might drive the men a little sexy.
Next question could have been the PBR hat.
I haven't worn that one in a long time. The cowboy hat. I haven't worn that in a while. Yeah. But, yeah, that. Well, I mean, let's be honest. Mike and Skeletor are both on their own level of freaking crazy.
Weird. Yeah.
And weird. So, I really don't know because they need a lot of psychological help. And I could try to help them, and I have tried to help them, but they are on a whole new level of batshit fucking crazy.
Yeah, and because we don't know where Mike works, and Skeleton allegedly works on an oil rig, so.
And that dude working on an oil rig gets drunk a lot. He probably needs a piece of ass, and he is also admitted that he really, really likes, you know, fucking Kluge. So, I mean, and Kluge does wear a lot of purple, and that's kind of Skeletor's color. So I'm thinking, like, he only hits on me to get to Kluge. But Mike,
yeah.
Mike, that Danny DeVito looking motherfucker, I just don't get him quite so well. And I don't think anybody on the show does, but we love our viewers, so we welcome them back all the time. And we'll deal with them because we enjoy their banter. So,
you've been served by Amanda.
Well, it's not Mike that she has to worry about. It's Skeletor.
Skeletor, too.
Yeah, she's aiming at the wrong guy. It's Skeletor that likes Kluge's balls.
I think Mike, though, does hit on Kluge.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. If I'm not around, he does hit on Kluge. But, Spoon, you say you don't need relationship advice anymore? Dude, I'm just trying to help. I'll help anybody.
He asked, are women mean to you? Because they sure as are hell mean to me.
Well, who asked that?
Spoon did.
Oh, I haven't really had a problem with women being mean to me. Ever.
Yeah. I would suggest.
There you go. Spoon, you should grow a beard, bro. Maybe that'll help you. Get yourself a nice beard going, or a goatee or something. I would suggest beard. I don't know how a goatee would work for you, but a beard.
Long hair too.
Long hair, yeah. Grow that shit out.
Off and on, I'll be in Walmart in my little scooter car, you know, because, you know, my knees issues, because it's hard for me to walk. I'm looking for something. All of a sudden, this, like, 67-year-old woman goes by me and goes, okay. And the other one goes, I want to sniff your hair. Okay. I look, and it looks like it was Skeletor, except for he put just the skin on him.
Oh, Jesus.
She was that skinny looking.
What? Why do you look like a bag of leather?
Exactly. So, on for the next question, unless someone comes up with one soon.
Spoon, I just got to teach you how to be smooth. That's it. You need to hang out with me a little bit, and I'll teach you how to be smooth.
Work for me, it'll work for you.
I got years of practice, brother.
Dear Dr. Sage, I've got a question for you, and I've been wondering. Should I actually buy an electric car or a stick that's gas-powered? I drive 40 minutes to work, and that dumbass in the White House keeps jacking the prices up for me with gas. Would you recommend an electric car? Signed, Roadrunner.
Never. I would never recommend an electric car. One, they're only going to last for so long. Those battery cells are eventually going to give out. And then you're going to pay for a new battery cell that's actually going to be more expensive than the car you actually buy. So,
and if you really look into it, to mine the lithium you need for those batteries, you're using gas anyway, and it's
gas and diesel
anyway.
So no, I would buy a fuel efficient car or a flex fuel efficient car, and do that way, because then you can run regular fuel or E85 fuel, and you'll get better gas mileage all the way around.
Right.
And not only that, but once this clown's out of office and we get somebody in there, the gas prices will go down. And he ain't got much time left anyway. So the gas prices will go down soon. And taxes will get better. Everything will get better. It's just we got to wait. And that's the hardest part. We have to wait for it and shit will go down. By the way, Will Height 2024.
Can't do any worse. Spoon, yep. I'm on a cloud every time I get high. So to answer your questions, yes, I stand on a cloud. Okay. Anyhow. Dear Dr. Sage.
Yes, that's me.
I heard AB is afraid of clowns. How can someone be afraid of clowns? Not taking shots, but I'm just wondering. Signed, Al.
Alien life form?
I guess.
Yeah, I've got the box set right over there. It's pretty badass. I still love Alf. He was always going after that cat. See, that's what I loved. Here's Alf, alien life form, always going after pussy. I mean a cat. But hey, he was a dude just like the rest of us.
You know, I wonder if that was all just a adult humor put in the
case. Oh, you know that was a metaphor. You know it was. He was always trying to eat that. No, never mind. But
I guess the question was how could someone be afraid of clowns?
Yeah.
How could someone be afraid of clowns?
I don't know. It's just a thing. Maybe Evie's had this all the time. And I don't know.
Something happened when she was a kid.
She was younger.
Yeah. And maybe that's why I'm not afraid of clowns and love horror movies, because when I was younger, when I was over my aunt's or at my dad's, they let me watch that stuff all the time.
And it's actually an actual phobia, too.
Right.
It's called like a choral phobia, something like that.
Hey, Siri.
I'm not sure how it's said or pronounced, but
what
it's like
the phobia of clowns called.
It's like choral phobia.
Fly.com. The fear of clowns is called chorophobia. While it's not technically a recognized mental health condition, if clowns make you anxious, you're not alone. And there's...
I think he said chorophobia. C-O-U-L-O-phobia. Chorophobia.
Yeah, and I don't know, and I think it stems back from like some of the older movies like It, and I think she actually mentioned the other day Killer Clowns from Outer Space is what triggered her back in her youth from seeing that movie.
What?
And, you know, that sticks with people. It's just like back in the day, Nightmare on Elm Street triggered a lot of people, and that scared them, and, you know, that people get scared of different things, just like Dan Spoon says right here. He's afraid of mice. My niece has a mouse out there right now, and I love it. I play with the little damn thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not afraid of anything.
What?
Except for running out of beer.
Right. And I'm running out of weed for me. You
know, so he's got a weed-phobia.
You know, a little rabbit trail real quick. You're talking about Killer Clowns from Outer Space. I can't remember, but there's two movies that shared those masks. I can't remember the other one. There was some movie like Ninja Turtles or Gremlins.
Well, Ninja Turtles 2, that mask was in whenever Donatello was in there and he was doing this. Like he took the clown off of that fucking thing. And one of those masks, I'm pretty sure, was that clown that was on the pedestal before.
Yeah,
and like
there was a movie that all the mask from Killer Clowns of Outer Space was in a movie before that, and they took Killer Clowns took those masks and repainted them. I just can't remember what movie it was because
I'm not really sure.
Anyhow, if anybody knows, let us know.
Yeah. If anybody can hear that one out.
Anybody else got Dr. Sage questions, put it in the chat or send us something.
that you're fucking Sage Ramsey. You fucking right, I'm Sage Ramsey. Yeah.
And, Amanda says she's scared of Freddy and zombies. Well, then you wouldn't like the show I watched today. There was two of them that were zombie movies. There was, I watched Night of the Living Dead. Actually, there was three black and white zombie movies. Night of the Living Dead, Carnival of Souls, and I watched Last Man on Earth. All three of the, oh, I also watched Last House on Haunted Hill, but that wasn't a zombie movie. Well, kind of. But anyway, the first three I mentioned are zombie movies, so.
Also Chucky.
Oh, that reminds me. If you're into horror movies and you like the TV show Chucky, I believe it's coming on in another week.
No, it started October 4th.
Did it?
Yeah.
I thought it was the 14th.
I'm pretty sure it was October 4th was the release date of when it started.
Hey, Siri.
The new season.
When is the Chucky TV series premiering this year?
Here's what I found from Wikipedia. The series premiered simultaneously.
No, that's not it, you dumbass.
You dumbass.
Well, let me go to the good old Book of Faces.
The good old Book of Faces.
Chucky TV series.
I'm pretty sure it was October 4th because they were doing like an hourly countdown to when it came on.
Pages. Let's see. That says two.
Manamana. Manamana.
Okay. Yeah, I think you were right.
Because
it's showing 3 hours ago, it says season three kicked off with a bang on the Book of Faces. it's good, guys. Two days ago. So, yeah, it was this Wednesday.
Booyah! The Dr. Sage is never wrong.
Well, looks like I'm going to be doing something tomorrow morning.
Masturbating.
That too.
Watching Chucky.
Because not only do I got Jed naked, I got April's legs, and I got the boobs of Irene.
Oh, man. You got it all. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
The only one I don't have is Carla, but I don't want that because that's your woman, so.
Oh, dear Carla. Did you send her an invite?
I don't have her on Facebook, so no.
I got this one.
I don't have Adam either, so I can't send it to Adam.
Shit, I didn't. I'll get back there.
I'm into a busy weekend. I had a lot.
Sure. Sure not.
Like a butterfly. Stinging like a bee.
The only one I don't have is Carla, but...
Sorry about the noise there. I'm going to send a message to Carla.
Dear Carla.
There it is. Let's see who else I can send that to real quick.
I got this one. I don't have that.
Oh, shit. I got to erase her name right there. Now I can send it to other people.
Sorry about the noise there.
I'll send it to him. I'm just going to send it to fucking all sorts of people. Oh, Alexis. I almost sent it to you.
No, that ain't the first time. Tyler always shares it to me all the time. The fucking millennial mook. Well, like I said, Spoon, I didn't say he's wrong. I just remember. And you know, that's probably why I didn't realize when it was, because I was in the middle of trying to figure out if Reservation Dogs had any more episodes, and I was watching the last episode of Ahsoka. So if you watch that, oh my goodness, it was the last episode of Ahsoka was really good. I didn't know whether to cry or be happy.
No, I would have done both. And, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Spoiler alert. So if you don't want to hear it, well, I'm warning you. Since Sage probably don't really care to watch it, I assume.
No.
Basically, what happened was you have to go back to watching the Clone Wars, a cartoon, to understand what I'm saying. So anyway, fast forward. There is this guy named Ezra who was fighting against this blue-faced guy called Thrawn. Well, in the Clone Wars, at the very end of it, they all went to a whole other galaxy.
Far, far away.
In the Star Wars galaxy, right?
Oh.
Well, in Ahsoka, they all went to where Thrawn was so that they get the bad guys that were trying to get Thrawn to go back. Well, the last episode, Ezra got on board the spaceship with Thrawn, but Thrawn didn't know yet. So he got to go back home and be with one of his best friends, which is a green-haired girl, green-haired, skinned, and long-eared girl called Hera. Because they used to all be together back in the Clone Wars. I think they call it Rebels, the Rebels TV show. So anyway, the reason why I'm saying I'm happy but sad is because I'm happy because Ezra got to go back home like he wanted to, but I'm sad because Ahsoka and a couple other of the main characters stayed on the planet where they went to. So that's how I'm happy but sad at the same time.
Hmm.
Which, if you watch the shows and movies, you'd understand. So, anyway, y'all can come back now.
Yeah. We only lost two viewers on that one.
Ain't the first time, I guess.
We lost two, game two, so it ain't so bad.
It could be worse. We could be a show that decided to do a show on Wednesday and only have one viewer.
Oh, yeah, no kidding. Yeah, that worked out really well for him.
And they try to be funny and call it something similar to what we're doing now.
Hey, Vincent, what's up, buddy?
What's up? What?
What you up to tonight?
My friend named his kid Vincent, mainly after Vincent Price, but I think Vincent is a cool name, though. See?
Look, oh, my God! What the... God, I'm deaf now.
I have all these cool burps, and Tyler ain't even here. Fucking millennial just had the fucking work.
Oh, yeah, you coming down to the show, bud? Shit, I might just have to take my gear then. I wasn't planning on suiting up and getting in a ring, but I mean, I might have to suit up. Getting that battle royal.
Yeah, the kid. When I was a kid, I still have them all, or most of them anyway. I used to collect all the wrestling figures, so I have a lot of Sting and 1-2-3 Kid, and all those ones of all different shapes and sizes. So I went and bought a ring, and I bought a whole bunch of generic wrestling belts for them. And I glued coins on them, and that was the belts, right? And I know I couldn't get by with it, but I called mine WWCW. Because I was in Woodford County, so I called it World Woodford County Wrestling. And I would have always, the thing is, I never would really have any matches. I would have just like a tournament bracket matches. And I would like be on top of like a desk or a chair, and I'd have Mick Foley come flying down at the guy doing dive bombs off of chairs and stuff and breaking through the tables, because I had all those tables and announced tables and everything. And I had Billy Gunn and all those. And now the two or three that I have now, I guess I'm one of the, because I'm older, I'm one of those people that don't even take things out of the package.
Oh, yeah.
And I have a Moxley and a Penta one. I really want to get one, two. I want to get three more for my collection.
Tiffany.
I
want
to take three more, but anyway. I want to get the Eddie Kingston one. I want to get the Rey Fénix one. And I want to get a Shayna Baszler one.
Oh, Shayna Baszler's one of my favorites.
If she wasn't married or have a boyfriend, she is the one wrestler, female wrestler, that I'd want to, you know.
Yes.
I don't know. Something about her statue and her size and everything that I gravitate towards something like that. I mean, oh.
Hello.
Right, but, you know. There's just something about it, you know. About that tomboy look.
You're right. Hello, Tiffany. Long time no speak. And thank you for the compliment on my glasses. My super thick glasses.
Anybody else have Dr. Sage questions?
Oh, yeah. Here comes Bubba. Shayna has no boobs.
That's fine. She does, but they're just right to where they're about.
Yeah, but I mean, she wears that freaking top that just sucks them on down. Right. So close to her body. You know what, Bubba? She may not have boobs, but she'd still whoop your ass.
Because if you look at some of her pictures,
fucking heartbeat.
Outside of her ring attire, if you've seen some of her other outfit she's been in, you can
actually. She's got titties then. I'm sorry, boobs.
Well, yeah, and then I don't know, but anyhow, I get what you're saying.
Tiffany, I can't believe you came in here. That is so crazy. I sent you an invite. I was all like, "Hey, ain't no way she's coming in." Then all of a sudden, bam!
There you go. Got one of your friends coming in. Share the link for everybody. Let's grow the family, as April would say.
Yeah, grow it.
As Mama April would say,
like my beard.
Caring. Yeah. See, I think that's another reason why I got a lot of chicks on me, because I started manicuring and making this look a little bit better. And I mean, I need to shave this off a little bit.
You should grow the whole thing.
I can't. This is all I can get.
Oh, what the hell?
I grow it here.
I do that too. I mean, shit, you know.
But I can't get it here, and that it sucks. Because I'd love to have a full beard. Don't worry, folks. He's not going raging on everybody. Saging on everybody.
God damn it, I got hair on there.
Now I know why you can you hear me? Okay. Now I know why you wearing it in a ponytail on the show. You get caught in your earphones.
Yeah, it gets caught and shit, and I was just like, fuck. Then I let it out and it's just like, okay, there it is. Fucking everywhere. Still long as fuck.
Yeah, like I said, you know, I had the short hair, and all of a sudden, as soon as I just started letting my hair fly, the women started flocking around. In fact, one time I was at, there's times where I used to go to the bars, and I'd have women come up to me and go, I want to run my hair through your
hair. I want to run my fingers through your hair.
Hair while we're having sex. I'm like, yeah, right, lady. You want to have sex with that guy? Come on now. I know you're lying.
Oh, Jesus.
And all those damn thirst traps on TikTok going, oh, and these hot-looking skinny chicks going, oh, my favorite are the fat guys that are over 300 pounds. I'm like, you're fucking lying, you dumb bitch.
Shit, I don't even qualify for that anymore. God damn it.
And see, here's the thing talking about fatness. I know I'm going on a lot of rabbit trails, but I can't think of anything.
Rabbit trails. Rabbit trails, rabbit holes. What are you going with here?
Squirrel.
Squirrel.
Anyway, fat people.
Mongoose. What?
Fat people. If you want to eat for free for a whole week, go to Las Vegas. And go to the Heart Attack Grill.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of that.
If you're over 350 pounds, eat free. There you go. You saved over $400 on food there. You just have to worry about a place to live, a place to stay.
You eat free at the Heart Attack Grill if you weigh over 300 pounds?
I believe so. 350 pounds, something like that.
What the hell? And yeah, yes,
they have an industrial size scale right outside the door. You come up to it, you stand on it, and it shows your weight. And if you're over 300 or 350 pounds, you eat free.
That's some bullshit. And yes, Tiffany, I see you joined, and I know you're not lame. You've never been lame. Hey, David, what up, buddy? You ready for tomorrow?
Another one of your buds?
Yeah, he's going to be my sound guy for tomorrow.
Right on.
Here's my DJ.
Wiki, 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 wiki.
That kind?
Well, he won't be spinning any records, but he's got all the equipment, all the sound, and all the thump, 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 thump. Yep.
The only thing spinning are going to be people when Dr. Sage,
Richard Neely,
someone upside the head with a twisted T.
Vincent says, will there be any food or anything? Dude, it's a carnival. There's going to be food.
You know what? The thing is, carnival food is so expensive, but so good.
Well, down there, it's not like a full-blown carnival type thing. So, I mean, there's going to be like food vendors there, and I don't think it's going to be too expensive.
Right. Oh, okay.
Because there's also going to be like the food trucks and different shit, but this is right. Also for like an anniversary of a Ford dealership, so there's going to be like independent people there doing food right and on. Shit. Getting ready to load up. Cool. Yeah, me too.
Since we're talking about that, do you have the card that you could show everybody? Talk about it a little bit.
I've got a card I can pull up on my phone,
or at least talk about it a little bit if you want, so that way people can know where to be and how much it costs and who's going to be wrestling and whatnot.
Hold on, just a second. I'm trying to find it here.
I think that'd be kind of interesting since it's tomorrow. So. Dave, I'm going to be loading up tonight when I get off on, I said get off, when the program ends.
I got to go out after the show and hook up the truck to the trailer, and then I've got like my tool bags I got to load up, and
right
in the morning I got to throw my gear in the truck, and I think I've got a few other things I got to load up tonight.
I got equipment too that I'm going to load up with some girl sometime soon.
Oh, snap.
Let's see. Hey, Lay, how you doing? Lay's another awesome person. She does really good paintings.
Hey, what's up, Lay?
You should have seen. You should have seen the Monopoly board she did on this table one time. She showed us. That thing was really flipping sweet.
Yep. Okay, where the
you're good artiste.
Flip is a match card. Gallery.
Hour 15-minute drive.
We're leaving by 10 or so. Like hour 15-minute. Yeah, I got to be down there by 8, so I got to leave at like
6:30, like 7 o'clock.
Like 6:45. Where the hell did I put it? Oh, it's got to be in Messenger. Oh, it's definitely not in Messenger. Facebook? Nope, it's not in there either. Screenshots? Oh, what the hell? Downloads. I know I got the card.
You might have to
there it is.
Wear clean underwear because of the awesomeness of seeing Sage down there, so you might shit your pants.
Dude, I need to wear clean socks. Dude, you can wear whatever you want to wear, bro. All right, for the RCW side, it looks like we've got Jeremy Lightfoot versus a guy named Ramsey Rancid. Remember, this is card subject to change. So we might have different people in different matches. Looks like we've got Juan Sanchez versus, Juan Sanchez and Skittles versus Dirty Dick Brody and Honky Tonk Kid. And then the freak pretty boy Floyd versus Wicked. And then on my side, Prairie Land Independent Wrestling, we've got Darian Frost versus Chase Brooks. We've got Kid Wright and Napier versus Robert and Raven Black. And Sid Holland versus Apocalypse. And then a 20-man battle royal for the RCW Championship.
Ooh, hey, and y'all never know. Maybe Sage is in it.
Yeah, maybe.
So you got to go and watch.
And, you know,
I
technically never lost that championship.
Yeah.
I got stripped of that championship, and that pissed me off, so I want that belt back.
So Sage is the real champion. Like someone from AEW. Hey, Hootie.
Any Hootie Hootie Booty Booty.
It's too damn cold out there. And now I know why people move south, but I still wouldn't want to move south.
Yeah, I've got my I didn't think I was gonna have to break out hoodies this early, but
I got my hoodies. You're gonna be wearing your Wrestling for a Cure hoodie?
It's either that or my PBR hoodie. I haven't quite decided. I've got them both and they're washed and hung up to dry. And
right on.
That, or I've got my Twisted Tea hoodie that I was too big for before, and now I'm down enough weight that it fits really good. So,
yeah. I've noticed that too since I'm losing weight. I can actually start to just fit in my 4X shirts. It doesn't look like I'm like overly tightening them, but anyway,
when I checked the weather earlier for tomorrow, let's see what it is again, see if it's changed any for a high. Still 61 for tomorrow. So yeah, 61, man, I didn't think I was gonna get this cool this quick. And why in the hell is he saying LA night? Oh, SmackDown, never mind, forgot, he's probably watching wrestling. LA night, yeah. I forgot him and John Cena got this program going on right now with going against the Uso shit, the Bloodline. That's right. But yeah, David, you can wear clean socks if you want. I mean, it's whatever. Nobody can be running around smelling your feet. But I need you there probably around 10. Jimmy and Solo. Oh, yeah. Well, we got probably about 15 minutes left. And then, so we'll be wrapping it up here pretty quick. You guys got any Dr. Sage questions or anything for Mr. 420?
Or do we got any jokes about the millennial whore?
Oh, yeah. You guys want to ask anything about the millennial whore?
Yeah.
Anything about the show tomorrow?
We'll answer questions for the millennial whore.
Oh, yeah. We absolutely will. Since we didn't have Mr. President or future President Jason Wilhite pop in, which I was thinking he would, but don't know what happened to him tonight. And Tim, he's probably working with Wieners.
Tim's working with Wieners and chocolate cakes, and
yeah.
Will Hite was probably busy.
Potatoes.
He's either busy on the campaign trail or trying to sell solar and help people with energy assistance.
Yeah. He's a busy guy. He does a lot. So. You never know with him.
That's why he needs to be president, because he can get shit done.
I got clean socks.
And he don't take shit from no one.
This is fact. And David says he's got clean socks, but the fart filter is questionable. Fair enough. We can work with that.
Fart filter.
But my brother Daniel will be there tomorrow to help you. And to help run music, because he's got his laptop, and you guys should be all set with that. Shouldn't have any issues whatsoever.
Shit.
Let's see here. I'll be down there earlier, setting up the ring and getting it all squared away and ready to go. I'm going to have to get to bed right after I get the truck loaded and the fucking trailer hooked up.
Right? Because you got to be up at, what, like 4 o'clock just to get ready and go?
Oh, no, I could be up and ready in fucking 10 minutes.
See, that's a millennial for you. They always have to get up super early. Whereas someone not like me. Us, we get up like half an hour before we need to be at work. We'll have a shit shower and shave and have something to eat and a coffee, and we'll get to work on time.
Yep. Yeah, I'll be I'll be pulling out of here right on time and be down the road quicker and shit.
Wow.
That's what he said.
My pull-out game is strong. Just failed. Just failed one time, apparently. Turkey baster. No, that was a turkey baster moment. Never mind.
I must be like Tyler there and have an air urethra.
Oh, fucking Tyler. But I think I got a pack of cooler. Pack a cooler tomorrow and take some beers down with me.
The show seemed pretty decent considering.
Yeah, we had I think we got up to 10 viewers at one point. So, I mean, that wasn't too bad. It's pretty close to normal.
I think just a lot of people just got super busy because it was actually nice for once.
Yeah. That, and we had a few different viewers in here tonight than normal.
Woo! Yeah, you had a few friends come over, which is cool.
Yeah.
A few regulars. So it's not bad for just us two, you know. It could be worse. It could be like another show and only have one viewer the whole time.
You right.
And it'd be boring.
And now next week, I won't be on Friday. I will be here. Yeah, I'll be in Branson.
Branson?
Yep. I'm going down for my annual trip. I'll be leaving Thursday.
You going to go see Dolly's boobies?
No. I'm going drinking and fishing and eating some good food.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, I see why people like these places. It's just, for some reason, beaches and places like that. It I don't know, for some reason, maybe it's because I'm old and I'm getting to that point of get off my lawn type of old.
Yeah. Oh, I got to answer this question real quick here. Where do I need to go on the grounds, and do I have to pay anything? No, David, you don't have to pay anything. Hey, Dana, what's up, girl? Should do miss that face. But back to you, Dave. Hey, there's Mr. President.
Who?
Jason Wilhite. But David, no, you don't have to pay anything to get on the grounds. It's at the Skyview Drive-In. You'll see all of us standing over by the wrestling ring. So just pull right in and come right into the right there at the Skyview Drive-In. Dana, how you been? Mr. President, are you here?
Mr. President?
Did somebody hack your system? Do we have to take them out? Oh, tired and busy. Well,
I think we're all that way. But anyhow, the reason stuff like that don't fascinate me anymore. Now, stuff that fascinates me is, like I always say and I always talk about, dirt track racing. Now I can go to just any track and have fun. And oddly enough, as loud as the place is, and noisy and dirty as a place is, it's a quiet, peaceful place for me. So how about you guys? What are your favorite things to visit? Like, do you like to go to Branson too, or do you like to go up to Chicago, or what's a bucket list? David, I'm sure he will answer that in the message, unless he comes back soon. He might be pulling a Tyler and having to go take a pee and whatnot. So, Branson, yeah, I know. I get it. I see a lot of people liking it. You know, it does look nice. It's just.
No, David, you're not going to have to wrestle anyone. And yeah, Branson is my favorite place to visit to. And that's why I'm going down there to the condo again and drink up some beers and eat. And holy bejeebus, 420. Didn't know this was a chugging contest.
See? I've been having good freaking burps all day long, all night long, and the millennial cart isn't even here.
And Will Height was here and just ditched and didn't say a word.
Maybe his phone's not working or computer's not working.
Oh, he's back.
Oh.
Hey, he might be having internet issues.
Or that.
Oh, yeah, I'll definitely send you some pics. Definitely send some pics of that trip.
Oh, I'm sure he'll show pics on Crackbook and...
Crackbook.
Facebook and...
Jesus.
Post it to his Instagram and Twitter and... Well, it's not Twitter anymore, it's X.
Yeah, it's X, yes.
Which, yeah, here's a funny thing about that. And you know, we try not to get political, but I just find it's kind of comical. People were pissed off because they couldn't be themselves and say what they wanted to say on Twitter, or else they'd get banned, right? All of a sudden, Elon buys it, and he makes it pretty much a free-for-all now. Mm-hmm. And now people are bitching and complaining because he opened it up and made it a free-for-all for anybody to say what they want. Make up your mind, people.
Well, people are never happy about anything.
I'm sure people are going to be bitching about this new guy that's in the House Speaker now, too.
Oh, he's probably on his way out already. At least that's what I think the Democrats are trying to do.
There's this, I do find it funny, or I wouldn't say funny, interesting though, that there are people in that are representatives at the House that want Trump as the House Speaker.
Oh yeah, that is funny as fuck. I think it'd be fucking great.
I am the House Speaker. What I say goes.
Not only that, but if he becomes the House Speaker, he can actually pardon himself of all this shit.
And you know what would be funnier? Since he's the House Speaker, if they fully impeach Biden and Kamala, he would technically be...
He becomes president, yes. It's a win-win. It's a win-win, people.
Okay, since we're talking about Trump, did he, like, foreclose or close down the Trump Tower or something in Chicago? Or?
Nah, I don't think so.
Because I see a lot of pictures around showing Spirit Halloween banners over the Trump logo and going, hey, and people pointing going, hey, and it's like, did they close that tower down or something?
No. They just, you know how they turn every closed location into a Spirit Halloween?
Right.
No, that's all malarkey and just.
Or they turn every closed, or they show a closed one and they put a Dollar General or
yeah.
A Dollar Tree.
And no, Trump Tower's isn't closed.
Here's what I kind of find odd about Dollar Tree. Okay, here in Pekin, I'm not joking. Where I live, exactly where I live, I have four Dollar General stores within 2 miles of me.
That's fucking ridiculous.
And two of those is about 8 blocks apart on the same road. That don't make sense to me, that one.
No.
But I see the other ones because one is down in a town, a small little town, 2-3 miles away. And then the other three are in the middle of town. Well, two of them are. And one of them's on the edge of town. But we also have two Dollar Trees, and one of them is huge, and the other one was
huge.
The smaller one. Huge. Huge. I tell you what. I'm a millennial whore. Bobby, there's no such thing as charcoal. Charcoal is a bastard thing. Is that how he does it?
It's been a long time since I've seen
Tyler.
Oh, shit. Jesus, I don't know.
Tyler Thankhill.
I'm really surprised he's not in here or hasn't been in at all tonight.
He must be pretty busy there.
I mean, watching doors can get pretty hard, but...
Yeah. He needs to watch doors because he don't need a lot of people stealing all that aluminum foil from there to be like Pee Wee Herman and make an aluminum foil ball.
Or, you know, he probably needs all that aluminum foil for himself for his hats.
That is right. So, speaking of that, the next photo might be of Tyler in a hat with some weird saying. So stick around to the Facebook page and keep on looking.
Yeah, you never know.
Yeah.
But we are at the 9 o'clock hour. So
Dave, there's no such thing as a stupid question.
It's true, my friend. So go ahead and ask questions tomorrow if you need to, whenever you're there, and we will answer as much as we can. But for now, 420, final thoughts.
Final thoughts. It is a pretty good show, just being us.
Yeah, just
the
two of us.
We answered a few questions for you. We had a few questions. I did part two of Stoner Thoughts. We talked about your wrestling organization this weekend, and it's where at again?
Litchfield at the Skyview Drive-In.
Litchfield at the Skyview Drive-In. And
free event.
Free event?
Yep.
Free event. There's going to be food vendors there, so bring a little bit of money, you know. But I'm sure there's going to be merchandise for the wrestling organizations. And
it's going to be carnival, everything. So
yeah, so a good old time, bring family event.
It starts at noon.
Wrestling, ride, get carnival food, and you know. Me, I'm going to be at Peoria at the races this Saturday. You know it's going to be freaking 55 degrees out, if not colder, there at night. But it's the first race I got to go to in the whole year. I didn't go to a race at all this year. I went at the very beginning of the year during the practice. I couldn't go because of the truck issue. Fucking Dodges.
Ugh.
And yeah, so your turn. Back to you, Dr. Sage.
All I got is a good show with it just being us two. Too bad Will Height. I'm guessing he's having technical difficulties, or maybe he's just waiting to come into this. Maybe. We'll be right back.
Maybe not. Might be another issue.
I'm guessing he's got technical difficulties.
Yeah. Nevertheless, Litchfield this weekend.
Yes.
I'm going to be at Peoria Speedway. So if you want to see either of us, go to one of those two places.
Yeah, and the wrestling activities start at noon.
There you go, everybody. Go see the wrestling, drive up to Peoria, and see me.
Yeah, the rest of the activities start at like 10 o'clock in the morning, but wrestling starts at noon. So we look to be done and wrapped up at about 2:30, 3 o'clock. The rest of the activities continue on throughout the day for a little while. And what is this? It's Kluge.
Hey, Kluge, you done playing with your balls?
Yep.
Oh.
Did you have a good bowling game?
Do what?
Did you have a good game?
Only the second game was decent. I bowled like shit tonight.
Oh, okay. Well, we have those days, so it's understandable.
Yeah. Oh, we had a pretty good show.
Pretty good. Decent. We had, what, an average of, what, five, you said? Five or so?
We got up to 10 at one point, and then it slowed back down to about 8 and then dropped down to about 5. So, I mean, we did pretty good.
Well, Adam is probably boning a pregnant chick, and Irene was probably boning her husband, so... Or getting boned by her husband.
Getting protein shots or something. I think that's what Tyler was doing all night at work, is getting protein shots. Because he never popped in.
Right.
He was taking protein shots in the mouth?
I'm pretty sure, yes.
While he was guarding a door.
Because normally Tyler will pop in on breaks and stuff, but he never popped in at all. And I think Will Height's having technical issues because he hasn't been able to come in all night. Like he's just had the blank screen the whole time.
April came in at the very beginning.
Yeah, she was in for about 20 minutes.
Yeah.
She was at work. But
and she got busy with a coworker, so.
Yeah, and then we haven't heard shit from Tim. But we were just doing final thoughts, so you got anything?
I haven't even heard the show tonight, so final thought. Tyler's a millennial douche.
Ha!
There we go. Good answer.
That's good, and you said you didn't do so good in bowling tonight.
No, I didn't even break 600 series for the night.
Ah, well, that sucks. But, hey, every now and then, average people have shitty nights.
Yeah.
Thank God I'm not average. I mean, thank 420 I'm not average. All right, guys. With that, we'll see you guys back here Wednesday night.
Will it be the full cast?
We never know if we'll have a full cast.
Facebook.
I should be able to be there.
And if you're on YouTube right now, bookmark it.
Yeah. But hopefully we'll see y'all back here on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. So come check us out.
All right. Titties.
Today, who said titties?
I like April and I like her rubbing on my penis.
Well, I think we'd all like that.
Well, dear Carla. How I love